have a rule that I never think of anything negative when I'm running. When I set my mind to something, I find a way to get it done.
She is so damn tough and loyal. When I met Jill, I knew. My brother said, there's this woman, you'll really like her, Jill. So I gave her a call, and she had a date that night.
You said, do you think you could break your date?
Oh, that's right. And what'd you do?
Well, I called and told the guy that I had a friend in from out of town and went out with Joe.
I was 30, and I was a senator, and I was a widower. Several years earlier, a tractor trailer broadside, my wife and three children, my wife was killed, and my daughter was killed. I wasn't big on the whole date scene thing. But when I met Jill, I fell in love with her when I saw her. I've got sunshine
on a cloudy day. He said, I'd really like to see you again. So he's looking at his calendar and he's, oh, Thursday. No, I'm really busy. No, I'm busy Friday. How about tomorrow? And I thought, buddy, you just blew your cover.
She's owned me since then. The boys fell in love with Jill, too. I'm brushing my teeth one morning, and they came running in, and Bo and Hunt said, Dad, we think it's time we marry Jill. Swear to God. Ooh, Jill. Asked her to marry me 5 times.
It wasn't just my heart that was on the line. I loved the boys so much. I had to be sure that it had to be forever.
Now, I'm going to ask you one more time. Will you marry me? She goes like this. Okay. She put us back together. She gave me back my life. She gave us back a family. We were raised with the same values.
I grew up in Willow Grove, Pennsylvania, right outside of Philly. My mom was English, Scottish, and my dad was Italian. My grandmother made the homemade noodles that would hang, you know, and she'd be drying her noodles.
They're a very close family. She's the eldest of 5 girls.
She's kind of like the godmother of all of us.
I think we've all seen the feistiness in her.
There was a bully in my school. She marched up the street and knocked on his door,
and I punched him right in the face. My father fought in World War II. He was a signalman in the Navy, and he was very patriotic. He would take us to watch the Blue Angels, and he was so proud. We worshiped our mother. I can picture her so well, reading for hours. She just loved to read, and that had a great influence on me. I went to college at the University of Delaware. Then I taught in the high schools. I mean, I got up every single day so excited to go teach. When I married Joe, I took off time to establish myself as the boy's mom. We don't use the term stepmother.
Bo and Hunt said, no, we have a mom and a mommy. Our mommy died. This is our mom. And then along came Ashley.
Our family was complete.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
When I was growing up, mom was fun. The headbutting started when I was a teenager. There was some conflicts. She dealt with it by taking up running. She started to basically run marathons.
I never, ever doubted that anything she set her mind to, she could do. I got to hand her her doctorate degree in education at the University of Delaware.
You passed, that's all you gotta do.
Well, let's turn it positive, so you will pass it.
I would say she's not your average grandmother.
Yeah.
She, you know, she's the grandmother who wakes you up at, like, what was it, like 5 a.m. on Christmas Eve to go soul cycling.
We have a lot of stories.
Yeah, she's a prankster. Yeah. She's very mischievous. Like, when she goes on a run, Sometimes she'll find like a dead snake and she'll pick it up and put it in a bag and she'll use it to scare someone.
Oh, that's a classic Jill. She wasn't really a Washington person and I don't think ever imagined herself being part of that.
When Joe was elected to vice president, I just thought, hey, I gotta step it up here because there are things that I really care about. Having had a father in the military, having a son deployed in Iraq, I saw the need to support military families.
Dr. Biden could draw anyone in, and they felt like they were talking to an old friend. That is one of her superpowers.
When she was second lady, Jill told me that she would like to continue teaching at community college. And I said, that's insane. You cannot possibly do that.
I said, I know I can do both jobs.
I never saw her on any day of the week where she wasn't carrying a huge stack of papers to grade.
As second lady, she was teaching full-time for 8 years, 15 credits a semester.
These were students who wanted to be in your classroom, and I saw their tenacity, and they were taking care of children just like I had done.
She gave 100% from her energy to the students. She's a great teacher.
Teaching is not what Jill does. It's who she is. Jill just simply cares. She cares about other people.
When Beau was diagnosed with brain cancer, nobody knew what we were going through. The Secret Service, you know, they're not supposed to react to your life or what you're doing. They would whisper, I'm praying for you.
Mom, it's your strength that holds this family together. And I know that you will make us whole again.
You never stop grieving, ever. But you do have to find purpose. Running for president is too tough to not be together.
The future First Lady of the United States.
That's right.
There you go.
If Dr. Biden is our First Lady, the country will be getting one of the best humans that we have.
She has been through some really tough things in her own life, and she knows how hard it can be.
The American people in their heart know that she'll fight like hell for them.
We all need community. We need to depend on others for our strength. All American families, we all need each other.